Okay. All right, everyone, let's go ahead and get started. Thanks for showing up on such a nice day out there. Finally, we've got good weather. But we have lots packed in, so we got to get started.
Yeah, we'll make it worth your while. So I have, in my 15 years at the University of Washington, I've often stayed up until 2 in the morning grading papers. But I've never stayed up until 2 in the morning grading papers when it was somebody else's job, and I was doing it anyway. And you guys made me do that twice this week with your ducks. Those were so much fun.
Carl emailed me. He called me a couple times because I was traveling, and now I've had a chance to look at them too. Carl called me. These are the greatest examples I've ever had in a class. So good job on that. We're going to go through a few of them.
Yeah. So I mean, I sent you on a duck hunt, and I want to just show people some of the amazing things that you guys found because it was so much fun, and I want to share it with everybody. Here's a wonderful duck. This is about the biggest bankruptcies in history, and the bankruptcies
are sinking ships.
Get it? And the colors represent the sector and so on. Here's another duck. This is alcohol consumption and academic performance.
Carl would probably be a K or something.
I would have gotten about a K. Yeah, you're right. This one was amazing. This one, we have no idea what this is. This is innovation.
What's innovation here? I have no clue what innovation is.
And why does it go down? And why? I mean, you can't really see it here so well, but it's actually measured in units of hundreds on the.
Maybe
on
the USB. Y-axis. Maybe the USB port means something here or something.
That one baffles me. I was really mad at this one and thought, oh my God, what a terrible duck. And then I saw Michigan, my hometown, was up top. And then
Carl's
I was like,
from Ann Arbor.
Not a duck at all. That's a.
I completely disagree with him because I'm not a Michigan fan. So.
So that's a, it's, yeah. This one is just one of the worst graphs I've ever seen. I have almost nothing to say about it. But you just can't, I mean.
Imagine if we gave a test on this kind of, on this particular graph.
How would you ever possibly
interpret
that? Yeah. And that's from the Wall Street Journal. This one I thought was wonderful. This is a pencil, and as you can see, what it's telling you is that business development erases happiness.
And you're all good. A lot of you will be going to business, so hopefully you'll switch them around somehow, have a different pencil.
I really like this one. The reason I put this one up.
it wasn't your fault. It was just the little graphics there. So.
Yeah. As not only did they supersize the meals, they supersized the Americans.
And we actually deleted it, or maybe we still have this one graphic.
Oh,
good. All right. There's one where Americans get made fun of again.
This one is a duck, and it's also just a terrible example of graphical design. It's got the axes reversed again, so it's coming down. I mean, why not just turn these needles upside down, right? And then there's just the immediate aversion you see when you see this, which may be partially deliberate, but it's certainly upsetting. And then you've got these plungers that are sort of getting in the way of interpreting what's going on. You've got these black lines up here that are adding this extra proportional ink, making it hard for you to see. Just an all-around terrible.
Now, one thing I will say, Carl and I have discussed this a little bit, because in the visualization literature, there are some studies that have shown that people do remember these duck graphs.
Fair.
It doesn't mean that they actually remember any of the data results, but they do remember that sort of offensive, you know, squirting ink syringe one or the sinking ships, but it doesn't mean they remember them. So there is some debates, and one thing that I want to challenge you to these examples are which ones could actually be both. Which ones could be a glass slipper and also a duck?
Here's an amazing one. You've got two data points and they go down, so why not connect them with a frown? This one was spectacular, I thought. Here the bar graph is also a picket fence, but it's been put into 3D perspective, so it just messes with your brain to try to interpret it when you try to see, because you're thinking like, oh, these are the same height bars. No, they're not. But it's 3D, but it's not.
But if I close an eye, maybe I'll see it a little
terrible.
Bit better.
Here, rising sea level, ocean waves.
Cute. How do you measure that?
How much people are eating? Forks.
Cool.
Bar graph.
This is a trace one. This is one of my favorite ones.
This one you've got, here you've actually got, you've got an attempt to show the relationships between two different variables, neither of which are time. We've got tuna prices, and here we've got average GDP growth, and we're just plotting how this is changing over time. And you can imagine following through this time course, and whoever did this noticed that it traced out a fish, and so they put a fish behind it.
That'll be your next assignment. You have to draw some sort of caricature of an animal.
Which is really cool, but it is quite hard to interpret. Here's Jevin's
favorite. There's another American. What's the deal with Americans being?
So this is average height. Jevin is noting that everybody is kind of buff except for the American, who's kind of rotund. There's some other issues. There's these terrible caricatures. One of the things that's really awful about the graph is that it's got a truncated axis. I mean, so these guys are different sizes, and then it's got a truncated axis at 1.5, and that's obscured by the fact that they've put their feet there. So, you know, at least you should have guys where you can see all the way to here versus some guys where you can just see the top of their head or something. But that's really sort of, I mean, I really can't see going much farther to hide visually a truncated axis. I love this one. I just love this one. The New York Times is usually so good. But the New York Times did this.
Oh, you could ask him, you know, how his baseball career is doing now since he's...
Yeah, there's Tim Tebow. That's... Was he playing for the Angels or something, I think, these days?
I don't know, but maybe...
Minor league? Does anybody know? Mets, thank you. From social media stardom, this is how many social media mentions do the different guys get in 2012 to a minor league career with the Mets. Here we've got a board game that is going to tell us something about responsive web design. I have no idea why, but it's a lovely duck.
Maybe they need to think about design a little bit more.
And finally, this one, I'm only a theoretical biologist, but I'm pretty sure these are chickens, not ducks. I'm a dad now, so I can make those kinds of jokes. Glass slippers. I asked people to find glass slippers. People found some new kinds that I hadn't seen before, I hadn't thought about before, and I want to show you a couple examples.
And I just want to make one comment about glass slippers are hard. Carl and I have spent hours trying to come up with these examples, and I don't know, maybe it took you hours too, but they were just like, they seemed so effortless from the way that, well, we were scrolling down through Canvas, so that makes it a little...
But people found wonderful ones. So here... When you look at this, you say, oh, this is just a donut chart. It's a fairly ugly version of a pie chart. There's no real reason to do it, but there's nothing wrong with it either. Except then you realize that none of these are actually percentages of anything. These are just numbers. These are just plain absolute values. 200K, 200K relative to what? 43 hours relative to what? 2 million relative to what? So these, how far they go around is just completely arbitrary. And they just want it to look like, they know that data graphics kind of look like this, and so if you do that, then it'll look like you've graphed something. And so it's totally meaningless. Beautiful glass slipper. Another lovely kind of glass slipper are these blueprints. We've seen a bunch of these. Blueprints are great, but blueprints of the Medicare system or a blueprint for success, it's just kind of silly. This was a great find. Whoever found this, congratulations. This is drawn as a tree graph, a tree plot. And what a tree plot is supposed to do is be a very clever way of representing hierarchical data, where you have clusters within clusters within clusters. But what's interesting about this is there's no hierarchy at all. This is flat data. And so what it ends up doing is giving you a very, essentially impossible to interpret bar graph that because you're changing both the x and y coordinates of each square. Without picking up any of the value of hierarchy. Yeah. Yeah, so these are the top GDP countries, and as you can see, it's using this style without actually representing any hierarchy. So delivered to the client, they're like, oh, that's so cool, everybody's using tree diagrams, but in fact, this is total duck. I want to finish up with this. I asked people to find new ducks, new glass slippers, but not old glass slippers. But this one was too beautiful. You got the glass slipper Disney connection. and then, you know, it turns out they've actually kept the letters from the periodic table and found, you know, they've actually shoehorned a character into every single element. But the thing that really blew my mind about this was that here was the title they put with it, the periodic table of Disney that will make you love science. So I want to know why in the hell it would make anybody love science instead of, say, hating all of humanity, which was my reaction. So anyway, thank you very much for doing this.
Yeah, thank you.
I mean, had so much fun going through those. And
it was one of the most entertaining grading sessions that Carl and I have ever had. I mean, Carl's been doing this a lot longer than I have.